This is the story of how a baboon became one of the best signalmen to ever work for a South African railway in 1890. His name was Jack the Baboon. Our story begins with Jack's soon-to-be owner, a double amputee signalman named James Jumper Wide. Now, some of you may think that Jumper is a bit of a cruel and ironic nickname for a man with no legs, but you'll be glad to hear that his nickname was completely unrelated to his injuries. Or maybe that's just even more cruel and ironic. Who knows? No, Jumper got his nickname from his former job as a railway cop. He was known to jump from car to car while pursuing railway criminals on the run. Unfortunately, one day he fell in between two of the cars and lost both of his legs from the knees down. Now unable to defend the sacred word of railway law, Jumper had to find himself a new job, and so he became a signalman. For any of you unfamiliar with the job, basically he had to sit in a little booth all day and pull levers, which activated different signals. That's pretty much all you need to know. The job itself wasn't horrible for Jumper, especially after he made himself a pair of wooden peg legs, but the mile or so he had to travel to and from work every day was a bit of an issue. He also made himself a small lever-operated cart to make the trip easier on himself, but even this wasn't much of an improvement. Then, one day while strolling through the marketplace, Jumper saw a miracle, a baboon driving an ox cart, completely on his own. Jumper went to find the owner of the primate, and with what must have been a truly impressive display of hornswoggling, Jumper was able to convince the owner to sell him the abnormally intelligent baboon, which he named Jack. The first thing Jumper taught Jack to do was drive the little cart thing to and from work, which Jack did with ease. Then he would chain Jack up outside the signal box and get to work. Another part of Jumper's job was to retrieve a key for the train's engineer whenever they sounded three consecutive whistles. Jack would watch Jumper do this and would eventually learn the correlation of the whistles and the key and started retrieving it himself. Which must have been pretty confusing to the engineer at first, just seeing some random baboon hand you a pair of keys, but whatever works, I guess. Through time, Jack eventually learned how to do the other parts of the job, and before he knew it, he was pulling all the right levers, sounding all the right signals, and he even did stuff like sweeping the floors and taking out the garbage, which meant that Jumper didn't have to do much of anything anymore. As I'm sure you can imagine, a dynamic signalman duo made up of a double amputee and a baboon was quite the sight to see, so it wasn't long before Jack the Baboon became something of a local celebrity, with train passengers going as far as to throw him treats as they passed. But not everyone was impressed. One day, as a particularly posh passenger passed the partner's post, she noticed that the on-duty signalman was, in fact, not a human, and complained to the railway company about it. When the company heard this, they decided not to fire Jumper outright, but rather to actually put his baboon's abilities to the test. Jack, not being one to disappoint, met and succeeded the company's expectations, as they realized that this baboon could perform as well as any human could. The railway company even made Jack an official employee, and this was the moment when Jack the Baboon became Jack the Signalman. Of course, being an employee, Jack needed payment. As such, an agreement was reached where Jack would be paid 20 cents and half a bottle of beer for every day that he worked, and reportedly he would not cooperate if he was denied his daily dose of liquid courage. Also, I would like to say that since this was in the 1800s, 20 cents then would be about $5 in today's money, which doesn't sound like a lot for a full day's work, but imagine paying a baboon $5 every day. Anyway, after working with the railway company for 9 years, Jack the Signalman eventually died from tuberculosis in 1890. His remains are kept in the Albany Museum in South Africa. This is sad, obviously, but I kind of love that he died from tuberculosis of all things, you know? I mean, it's not like he was poached or something. He didn't die an animal's death. He died from a disease that a lot of people died from at the time, and I think that's just a really appropriate way for him to go out. Also, it's worth mentioning that in those 9 years of working for the railway, Jack never made a single mistake. Not one. I kind of want a version of this story from an alternate timeline where Jumper worked as a defense attorney or something, and his pet baboon just kind of stumbled his way to becoming the best lawyer this side of the Serengeti. Anyway, that's the story of Jack the Baboon. If you liked it, then check out another video that I made a few months ago about weirdly intelligent animals. I think you might like it. Also, if you don't subscribe, then it's possible you will lose both of your legs in a terrible train accident. I mean, I don't know for sure, but why would you leave something like that to risk? Better be safe than sorry, that's all I'm saying. Anyway, that's all I have for you guys today, and until next time, don't die. Sayonara.